Hello, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. UWB one of the most interesting projects to represent real movement in a virtual environment in real time. UWB chip can measure the distance between UWB sensors by the time of flight measurement. Using this from the previous UWB project, I was able to represent a 2D position in a plane in real time in a virtual environment with two anchor devices and one tech device. If you haven't watched it yet, I hope you do. You can see how I walk. In this project, by adding two anchors, using a total of four anchors and one tech device, I'm trying to represent the movement of reality in a 3D virtual world. In short, it's transition from 2D to 3D. Here are five UWB modules are prepared. They are all self-made PCBs and ESP32 as a microcontroller, and it uses BU01 as its UWB chip. Only the tech device has a display. The purpose of this is to immediately check how far away from each anchor is connected. Let's connect the power to the prepared modules. First, if you look at the tech device, you can see that A, B, C, D are separated. Here, you will see how far each anchor is from the tech. When the power is connected to the anchor, communication with the tech device starts immediately. Then you can get each current distance through the tech device. All four anchors are connected and the distance is displayed without any problem. In order to get more accurate results, I had to analyze the distance data between the two UWBs. I created distance data measured in ToF against the actual distance while moving between the tag and the anchor by each 10 cm up to 3 meters. And I repeated this several times. This is the dataset I got from my experiment. First, in the chart on the left, blue is the distance data obtained from the sensor, and orange is the actual distance data. When the tag and anchor are 10 cm away, the distance obtained from the ToF is approximately 50 cm. If you look at the last data this time, when they are actually 3 meters away, the distance obtained from the ToF distance is about 4.3 meters. We can note that the greater distance between the two devices, the greater the error. The chart on the right shows the trend line for ToF. This shows the data is linear. The slope is newly calculated so that the ToF distance is close to the real distance. This definitely helps to get closer to the actual distance. By applying a new formula to the tag and used to reduce the error in the distance from the anchor, I wanted to check if the error is really reduced through this experiment. Anchors were placed 0.5 meters, 1 meter, 1.5 meters, and 2 meters away from the tag respectively. And go back to the tag device, you can see that it's displayed a very similar distance to the actual distance. This may be different from yours because I tested it with my own devices, also it can be affected by the surrounding environment. So I recommend that you test it in your own environment. And this is the environment I created for actual testing. Two anchors are placed horizontally and two anchors are placed vertically. All anchors are fixed, only the tag moves. All data obtained from the tag is transferred to Unity through UDP, and Unity calculates the data in real time and displays the X, Y, and Z positions of the tag in the virtual environment. This is my space for testing. This is my backyard. As shown on the screen, the anchors are placed like this and the tech device is placed on the portable hand ramp. I'm trying to use this hand ramp like an item in the game. Let me grab this and move it. In the bottom right corner, you will see the Unity screen. You can think of the red circles in the left and right views as a white chair in the real world. The recording camera had to be positioned on the other side, but there was no room for the camera, so Unity's screen is flipped. Please understand this. All of my movements are being displayed in the virtual environment. Let's talk about the data sampling rate. As the number of anchors connected to a tag increases, the sampling rate decreases. If four anchors are connected at the same time, only four or five data can be received from each anchor per second on the tag device. That is slow to immediately reflect real-world movements. The Unity screen you see right now is about 1 second faster. To make the perfect real-time calculations, we need to acquire data in a different way. In my opinion, the sampling rate can be much higher by sending the tag distance data from each anchor to the server instead of processing everything in the tag. Tag device is too busy to do everything alone. The system is not yet perfect, but I think it has a potential and is a first step towards making it possible to interact with real and virtual environments. Aside from the slow data sampling, the representation of the hand ramp's location in the virtual environment is really good. Perhaps this project will continue. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.